All right, so the affirmative wants to ban assault weapons because they believe that they are favored by killers, by mass killers specifically, in their terms. And I don't think that 7% is used to define favorable selection. I think 93% of other weapons might be a better choice and a better topic to debate. Rachel Wolf, Vox.com, claims that a semi-automatic rifle is used in 11 of 156 of all of these major events. The other issue that we need to address is that the number of self-defense shootings went up and the number of mass killings went down in the last couple of years. The number that Andrea tried to correct me on was actually related to mass shootings, not the number of overall gun deaths. Additionally, accidental shootings were dropped by 9%, and only 4 states have some form of law requiring gun owners to safely store their weapons, meaning that kids can't get to them or people that aren't authorized can't use them. So that number actually dropped by 9%. The incidence of defensive gun use increased slightly from 1,979 in 2016 to 2,030 in 2017. The majority of gun owners cite self-defense as their primary reason for owning a gun. And this was recorded by an article called Gun Deaths Increased in 2017 from Gun Violence Archives. Data by thetrace.com or thetrace.org. They also cite that young people were the main killers, and they're talking about recent events. And on top of that, Daniel Webster, a professor who works for the Johns Hopkins Center for Gun Policy and Research, said that far more young people ages 18 to 20 commit violent crimes with handguns than they do with assault weapons. So I think that kind of shows right there that young people more have an issue or don't have an issue with choosing their weapons, and even if they do have handguns, they probably obtain them illegally because they have to be 21 to purchase handguns anyway, showing that people aren't following the current laws. And while 2017 was marked by multiple high-profile shootings, mass shootings specifically, including the massacre in Las Vegas and Sutherland Springs in Texas, the year-end tally of mass shootings was slightly less, not the statistic of more people being killed every single year. I'd also like to note that Andrea's citation of Vox.com as an agency citing the number of people who were killed by mental illness is not really a credible source. I think it would be better to use the Mother Jones mass shooting database because they actually verify each person that had a mental illness. And again, that was 54 out of 100 that were confirmed mental illness, 26 where it was unclear or is still being investigated, and only 20 that they could confirm that were not mental illness. And so it is an issue and it's something that needs to be addressed. And because assault weapons are only used, not only, but used 7% of the time, and it's obviously more than half the time that mental illness is a factor. It doesn't matter what weapon is used. It's just about reforming laws and enforcing them. And the number of people killed in mass shootings also declined from 456 to 433. And in previous years, fatalities from mass shootings continued to make up a small fraction of overall firearms deaths, which was less than 3% of the total firearms deaths.